Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello, my name is Maria Tukipia and I'm from class 2C. Okay, here I want to explain about manner of articulation and place of articulation. For the first, I want to explain about manner of articulation. Manner of articulation is the configuration and interaction of the articulator, speech organs such as tongue, lip, and palate when making a speech sound. Atau yang lebih mudah lagi bisa kita katakan, manner of articulation is how to produce a speech sound. Jadi, manner of artikulasi ini adalah cara bagaimana kita membuat sebuah suara atau interaksi antara alat artikulator seperti lidah, bibir, dan langit-langit untuk membuat sebuah suara. And here, there are six manners of articulation. And I want to explain one by one. For the first is stop. Stop is sound produced by blocking the airstream completely and then releasing it in a burst of air. Atau suara yang dihasilkan dengan memblok aliran suara dan kemudian melepaskannya dalam semburan udara. I want to give an example is peh. Peh. Kita menahan udara dan dihempaskan begitu saja. Puh. And I want to give an example. Buh. Okay, I want to put it in the word pen. In the word pen, there are three sounds: p, e, and n. Okay, I want to give an example from b. Back. In the word back, there are three sounds: b, e, and k. Okay, for the second is fricative. Fricative, consonant produced by a partial obstruction of the airstream. Konsonan suara yang dihasilkan oleh obstruksi parsial aliran suara. And here, I want to give an example. And okay. And now I want to put it in the word fast. In the word fast, there are three sounds: f, e, and s. And I want to put the word have. In the word have, there are three sounds: h, e, and v. Okay. For the next is affricative. Affricative is sound that have a combination of stop and affricative. The affricative itu adalah suara yang memiliki kombinasi dari stop dan fricative. Jadi kombinasi antara cara stop dan cara fricative. And here, I want to give an example. In the word cheek. And in the word cheek, there are three sounds: ch, i, and k. And I want to put I want to give an example from j. Is jam. In the word jam, there are three sounds: j, e, and m. Okay, for the next is nasal. Sound produced with the airstream passing through the nose. Jadi suara yang dihasilkan dengan aliran udara melalui hidung. Jadi aliran udaranya dikeluarkan melalui hidung. In example, Jadi aliran udaranya kita keluarkan melalui hidung. And N. And now I want to give an example. Mad. In the sound mad, there are three sounds: m, m, e, and d. And I want to give an example from n. No. 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 In the word no, there are two sounds, n and o. Okay, for the next is liquid. Konsonan where the air stream passes through the mouth in a fluid manner. Jadi konsonan di mana aliran udara melewati mulut dengan cara yang cair atau cara yang basah. Misalnya, and here I want to give an example. Luck. And and here I want to give an example. Luck. In luck, there are three sounds. U, and K. Okay, and for the last is glide. Sound produced with a relatively wide opening of the mouth and little turbulence. Suara yang dihasilkan dengan bukaan mulut yang lumayan lebar, yang relatif lebar, dan sedikit turbulence atau getaran. And here I want to give an example. Wuh. 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 And yeh. Yeh. Jadi mulut terbuka lumayan lebar ya. Wuh and yeh. And here I want to give an example. Wet. 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 In wet, in the word wet, there are three sounds, w, e, and t. And here I want to give an example from ye. Yes. 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 In the word yes, there are three sounds, ye, e, and s. Okay, now we jump to place of articulation. Okay, and now I want to explain about place of articulation. Place of articulation is the location at which two speech organs approach or come together in producing a speech sound. Atau yang lebih mudahnya kita bisa katakan place of articulation is where to make a sound. Jadi speech place of articulation itu adalah tempat di mana kita untuk membuat sebuah suara. And here there are six places of articulation. And now I want to explain one by one. For the first is bilabial. Bilabial consonant occur when you block airflow out of the mouth by bringing your lips together atau sound produced with both lips. Jadi untuk bilabial itu adalah ketika kamu memblok udara dengan cara menyatukan bibir. Jadi bibir antara bibir bawah dan bibir atas itu kita bertemu. Is such I want to give an example here. Puh. Jadi bibir bawah dengan bibir atas itu menyatu. P. P. M. B. 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 Okay, I want to put it in the word put. Put. In the word put, there are three sounds. P, U, and P. And here I want to give an example from B. Big. 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 In the word big, there are three sounds, B, I, and G. Okay, for the next is labiodental. Labiodental consonant occur is made by the top teeth touching the lower lip. Jadi, menahan aliran udara dengan gigi atas menyentuh bibir bawah. I want to give an example. Jadi, gigi atas menyentuh bibir bawah ya. And and now I want to put it in the word fast. 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 And have. 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 Okay, for the next, interdental. Interdental sound produced with the tip of the tongue between the tongue. Jadi bunyi yang dihasilkan dengan ujung lidah di antara lidah. Okay, here I want to give in sorry, and here I want to put it the example. And okay, and now I want to put it in the word thick. ujung lidah, di antara lidah. Sik, sik, and z, 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 z. Okay, for the next is alveolar. Sound produced by the tip of the tongue touching the approaching the alveolar ridge. Jadi bunyi yang dihasilkan oleh ujung lidah yang menyentuh alveolar ridge yang mendekati. Alveolar itu adalah gusi ya, gusi. Jadi di sini ketika kita mengangkat ujung lidah bertemu dengan gusi-gusi yang mendekat dengan gigi. I want to put it in the sentence. I want to put it in example. Lihat ujung lidah bertemu dengan gusi gigi ya. And d, d, d. Okay. I want to put in the word nap, nap, nap. In the word nap, there are three sounds, n, and p. And from d is bed, bed, bed. In the word bed, there are three sounds, b, e, and d. Okay, for the next, alveolar palatal. Sound produced with the blade of the tongue approaching the hard palate. Jadi suara yang dihasilkan dengan bilah lidah mendekati langit-langit yang keras. Di langit-langit yang keras yang ada di atas. And here I want to give an example. Jadi lidah, tengah lidah itu menyentuh atau mendekati dengan langit-langit yang keras yang di atas. And okay, and now I want to give an example. Shot, shot, shot. Okay, and I want to give an example. Chick, chick, or champion, champion. Okay, and now for the last is velar. Velar adalah bunyi yang dihasilkan dengan bagian belakang lidah menyentuh velus atau langit-langit lunak. I want to give an example. K, k, k. Jadi lidah bagian belakang itu menyentuh langit-langit yang di belakang langit-langit keras atau disebut juga velus atau langit-langit lunak. K, k, and w, w. And now I want to give an example in the word key, key, key. In the word key, there are three sounds, k, e, and y. Okay. Maybe enough here from me. Kalau ada kesalahan, mohon dimaafkan. And the last, wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.